Somebody's saying yes to change. I know somebody want to bring change back to their family.
Will your spirit still say yes?
Hallelujah. Just open up right where you are.
There is more than I require of thee.
And if you're saying yes right now, just come right
here. Will your
right time here.
Say yes. Now will your heart say yes? Will your spirit still say yes?
Yes,
if I told you,
yes,
I really need,
Jesus.
Would your heart and soul,
hallelujah, Jesus, and the Lord,
now will your heart and soul say? Will your spirit still say yes?
Let your spirit say yes to change.
Yes, Lord. God is saying, there is more than I require of thee.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Will your heart
I'm the Cicero family. They lost so many this year. But how did you know you can take authority? Come on, for such a time as this. Why did God save you anyway? Why did God save you? He saved you to glorify himself. But he saved you because he knew that you needed it. How many of y'all said, I got saved right on time? How many of you can say, I got saved right on time? If I hadn't got saved the day that I got saved. March 17th, 1978, I gave my first message. And it was called, What Is Your Life? It Is But a Mere Vapor. A man that had just been released from Tehachapi prison, worked for the mafia, looked at me, sat in the front row. My first message was prophetic. And I was preaching, What Is Your Life? It Is But a Mere Vapor. He just sat there and looked at me with his hands folded like, yeah. He didn't get up. 48 hours later, he was shot dead in the alley across the street from my house. I preached a Friday night. That following Thursday, I was singing growing up yonder at his funeral. You think tomorrow is your day. Come on. If you need prayer, I suggest you get up here. Say, Lord, I'm not sure if I'm saved. If you say, Lord, I just need strength. I want to be saved, but there's so much in my life. I want to be saved, but if you just come up here for prayer, come on. If you just come up for prayer and say, Lord, I need strength. We got preachers up here right now. Some of you need healing. Come on, God said, there's so much I'm requiring of you. How many of you know there's more in God that you need to do? How many of you have more in God that you need to say, God, I know my life needs more. I just don't know where to get out of it. But these people at the army, they know how. They've been taught and anointed by God to be a blessing to you, to strengthen you. Nobody's here to talk about you. Nobody's here to tell your business. We're here because we want better for you. Don't sit by the pool and wait for somebody else to push you in. But you need to learn to get up and walk into the pool yourself. These preachers are anointed. They've been praying and fasting. Come on. There's more that God requires from you. How many of you know there's more that God requires? How many of you know there's more that God requires? That God is more in my life is how I'm living. There's more in my life than what I'm doing. I don't know what it is.